Hi everyone, my name's John, and in this video I'm going to show you exactly the methods that I use to sprout all these stephanias here, and I really hope that this information will help you to sprout your stephanias successfully. So let's check it out. All right, so I had originally ordered 3 stephania erectas maybe 2 years ago-ish, and I got those all to sprout together using certain methods, and then since then I've got this stephania nova, and I did things a little bit differently, and I do feel like that second method I used worked a little bit better, so I'll walk you through all of that today and you can decide for yourself. But whatever method you choose, either of mine or your own, there are 2 things that you're going to need. First, you're going to need a growing medium that's really chunky and well aerated. So you could use pure perlite, pure pumice, you can use LECA, any kind of gritty mix. The goal is to make sure that that potting medium holds moisture but has so much air that the caudex just will not rot, no matter what. Unless things go terribly wrong, it's possible, but if you make sure, if you prioritize giving that caudex a chunky, well-aerated growing medium, then there's a really high chance that it will not rot, and so eventually, even though it might take a long time, it is going to root for you. So the second key is that high humidity. High humidity helps these so much. It's gonna speed it along incredibly. Even with high humidity, it still can be a pretty long process. So I can't even imagine doing it without, but you can use a Ziploc bag, you can use a Tupperware, you can use a clear plastic grow bin, a greenhouse would be amazing. The humidity really helps get these going. They feel very comfortable in that humidity. And since we're using such a chunky and well aerated growing medium, it's going to tend to dry out very quickly. So the humidity is gonna help keep a little more moisture in there for a longer period of time, but you're still gonna be able to add fresh water, fresh nutrients every week or so, depending on what exact potting medium you choose. So let's go over the methods that I have done personally, and you can just choose whatever sounds best for you. So I purchased 3 stephania erectas. I put them all in a pot full of LECA. I planted them pretty deep. I know that LECA has, there's huge air spaces in there, so I was pretty confident it wouldn't rot no matter what. Then I stuck some chopsticks in and I put a clear Ziploc bag over those, and the chopsticks just helped the bag from collapsing. And eventually it worked. I started to see these little nubs coming up on 2 out of those 3 caudexes. And at that point I decided to take all of them and put them into 1 pot of inorganic gritty mix. It was equal parts pumice, lava, and turface. I had decided that rather than watering 3 pots of stephanias all year long, I just wanted to water 1 pot that had 3 stephanias. So I put them into there, I covered them with a Tupperware, with a desk lamp right up above, blasting down, and they started to leaf out pretty quickly at that point. So that was great. So I started them in LECA, moved them to the inorganic gritty mix. Life was good. I kept them in the gritty mix for a long time. When I finally did want to separate them, I was very surprised at the massive, massive root system on some of those plants. One in particular had an insane amount of roots, which you may have seen in my other video. So since then, those 2 have been growing in just pure diatomaceous earth, which has been really good. It's a very, very wet choice for gritty mix. So outside of these humidity bins, it works really well. Inside the bins, it's not that good. It stays wet for a long time. My plants in other gritty mixes do much better than the diatomaceous earth in the bins. Outside of the bins, really great option. So eventually I got the stephania nova, which was originally the one I had wanted, but it's a lot more expensive than the erectas. But I finally got it. Such a cool plant. But what I chose to do with this one, I actually just went with the jar of perlite method, which you might have seen in my magical propagation method video. So I filled a glass jar of perlite. I had already sifted all of the dust out, and I just planted the caudex in there, poured some filtered water in so that there was a tiny, like 1/8 inch or so layer of water at the bottom, put it in the bin and just left it alone. After about a month or so, I still didn't see any roots, and I was a little surprised by that. But one of the benefits to propagating in perlite is that it's so light and fluffy that if you want to pull a plant out once a month to check on it, it's probably going to be fine. There's not a very high chance that you will damage the root system. So I plucked it out. I saw a handful of roots. And so at that point, I switched it into this salsa cup with holes drilled in it. And I chose to put it in half bark, half perlite. And the reason for that is that the bark will just add a little bit more moisture, but it still kept everything super chunky. So all the dust still sifted out. Now, I wanted to move it into a wetter mix, but it was the middle of winter, and so I needed to keep it in the grow bins for a couple more months. So I chose this bark and perlite mix, and it's actually worked really well. You can see it's got these four nice leaves. The root system is looking really good. Super, super white. It's made its way through this whole container. So I'm definitely pleased to have so far gone 4 for 4 with my Stephanias. And if you're wondering where the fourth one is, where's that massive one from the other video? I moved recently and I chose to leave that one with my previous roommate because I took these three instead, let her have the big one. I like the small ones anyways. But yeah, it's fine. It's still very healthy. It's doing well. Thanks for asking. Okay, so all of these methods worked. Similar methods will definitely work as well. But I really like the perlite in the jar method because it's so hands-free. You just stick it in the jar of perlite, put it in the bin or under the Tupperware, and just leave it alone. It's gonna be fine. I've propagated enough things over the past year or so in perlite and still had 100% success that, at least for me, when I do that method, my worry is almost zero. I still gonna worry a little bit for something that means a lot to me. Like it's not like I can just grab another cutting of a Stephania Nova somewhere and try again. This is the only one I've ever had, and so I use the method that has yet to fail me. Okay, so now that things are heating up, we're into March now. I've moved, I've got a southeast window in my room. It's super bright and amazing. I'm moving this Stephania Nova into a wetter mix. And so I wanted to repot for this video to show you all the root system so you can see what you're dealing with. And because in general for me this year, I'm moving most of my plants towards wetter mixes. I think I've just been doing way too much watering, and I think I've trimmed my collection down as much as I can for now. I just absolutely love all these plants that I still have, so I want to just lift some of the burden of watering. So yeah, I am going to move this into a new mix. It's going to be wetter than anything I've done a Caudex plant in before, but I'm confident it's going to be fine, so I'll definitely update you all later on if it isn't. But what I've chosen to go with is a mix that is 2 parts potting soil, 1 part bark dust, 1 part lava, and 1 part turface. I just have a feeling that's going to be really good, because one thing I noticed last year is that there was one point where my Stephania erectus had stopped growing, and I was still afraid of overwatering them, just because you hear about Caudex's rotting. That's like the main issue anyone would have. So eventually one of my friends was like, dude, you gotta water those things more. I started watering them every day, and within a week, they all were growing again. And remember, this was 3 of them sharing a pot of inorganic gritty mix. So they were really using that moisture up super quickly. But that just showed me that when these are growing and they're getting a lot of light, I had them right in the window, which I'm doing again. They are actually very thirsty plants during their growing season. So after you've got them to grow that root system in that really chunky mixture, I really think we could be growing these in wetter mixes and just have them do their thing with a lot less effort. But I'm gonna experiment and let you all know. So look out for an update later on about that. All right, so if this is too much information, I do have a blog post I wrote about sprouting all my erectas. There's tons of info there and a lot of photographs showing the whole process. So for sure go check that out. I'll leave a link down below. Okay, so I think we're ready to repot. Let's try it out. Okay, so here's all 3 of them, and actually the 2 Stephania erectas on the sides, I actually removed all the leaves from those about 2 months ago just to see if they would bush out. And this one grew a new stem. You can see the old stem just dried up, but it's really hard. Like, I don't want to break it off. I have to cut it. This guy here just has these 2 little nubs coming up, so he's taking his time, but he's definitely doing all right. So you can see how chunky this mix is, bark and perlite, and these glorious leaves. So time to give it a wetter mix today. All right, so let's get this thing out of here. Should be pretty easy, unless the roots are stuck to the side. Sorry, my friend. Nope, all right. Well, there may or may not be a small amount of roots still in here. So here we go. So I'm not gonna really worry about getting all this perlite and bark off, because that's just gonna, it's not gonna matter. There's perlite and bark in the new mix, so I can just leave that. All right, so hopefully this will be its home for the next couple of years. Okay, so this is one of my all-time favorite plant and pot combos. Woo! Okay, so I really hope this helped you. I'm really happy with the way this is looking. It did lose a bit of roots because they were stuck to the inside of that cup, but it still has plenty of roots. Definitely like over 60% of the roots are still on the plant at least. So it's gonna be all right. We'll see what happens with this guy, which I just chopped with a bucket on accident. When I went to move the bucket of soil back behind here, I accidentally nicked this. Look at that. So this is what it was doing earlier. I don't know if it's gonna fall off or if it's gonna heal. I might try to like tape it or something to get it to heal. But again, the caudex has so much energy stored in there. The root system is healthy. We're good. Okay, so that's gonna do it. So thank you so much for watching. I really hope this helped you. If there's something you're still wondering about or if I left something out, just let me know. Reach out to me in the comments section. If you enjoyed the video, please let me know by giving me a thumbs up. And I hope that more and more of you will consider subscribing if you have not already. We're quickly approaching spring now, so it's gonna be a ton of plant content happening constantly here in my room in this new home. So stay tuned for that. And thank you again so much for watching. I hope to see you in the next video. All right, have a good one. Peace.